Hello students, welcome back to Engineers Academy. Kindly subscribe my channel for the solution of such more problems. Now I am going to solve this problem. In this problem it is said that determine the resultant R of the four forces acting on the gusset plate. Also find the magnitude of R and the angle theta x which the resultant makes with the x-axis, right? So we are required to find the resultant of these four forces and the angle of that resultant with the positive x-axis, right? So for that, our x will be equal to the summation of all forces along x, and similarly our y will be equal to the summation of all forces along y. So to apply these two conditions, we have to resolve these forces into its components, right? So if I resolve this 60 kN force into its components, right? So then it will have one component in this direction, and it will have one component in this direction, right? So this one will be the cos component, right? So we can say that this will be 60 cos of 40 degrees, and this one will be 60 sine of 40 degrees. Similarly, if we resolve this 50 kN force into its components, right? So it will have one component in this direction, right? And similarly, it will have one component in this direction. Right, and again this one will be the cos component, so we can say that this will be 50 cos of 20 degrees and this one will be 50 sine of 20 degrees. Similarly, if we resolve this 30 kN force into its components, right, so it will have one component in this direction. This one will be the cos component, this one will be 30 cos of 20 degrees, and it will have one component which will be acting in this direction. This one will be the sine component, right? So we can write that this will be 30 sine of 20 degrees, and this 40 kN force is acting in the positive y direction. This is our positive y direction. This is given, right? And this is positive x. So the summation of all forces along x will give us the Rx component of the resultant, right? So Rx will be equal to, so this cos component is acting in the positive x direction, so I will write 60 cos of 40 degrees. Similarly, this sine component is acting in the positive x direction, so I will write plus 50 sine of 20 degrees, and this cos component is acting in the negative x direction, so I will write minus, this is 30 cos of 20 degrees. Remember that this direction, this is the positive x direction, and this one is the positive y direction. This is positive x, and this is positive y, right? And similarly, Ry will be equal to the summation of all forces along y, right? So now as we can see that this sine component is acting in the positive y direction, so I will write plus 30 sine of 20 degrees. Similarly, this cos component is acting in the negative y direction, so I will write minus 50 cos of 20 degrees. Similarly, this 40 kN is acting in the positive y, so I will write plus 40. And this sine component is acting in the positive y direction, so I will write plus 60 sine of 40 degrees. So when we solve this, so our x component is equal to 34.87 kN and the Ry component is 41.84 kN. So the resultant magnitude will be equal to our x square plus Ry square under the root 2, right? And if I draw the resultant, right, so if we draw the resultant, so its one component is acting in the positive x direction and that magnitude is 34.87, right? So let's say that this is the component of the resultant which is acting in the positive x direction, right? And similarly, it will have one component which is 41.84 and that is acting in the positive y direction, right? So this is the component which is acting in the y direction, right? And if we add both of these components, so they will give us the resultant, and the resultant will be acting in this direction, right? So let's say this is that resultant, right? So this is the magnitude of that resultant, which is given by this equation, which is Rx square. So Rx is 34.87 whole square, and Ry is 41.84 whole square. This will give us the resultant magnitude, right? And if I bring this component of the resultant here, right, so then this is the angle theta of this resultant, right? So this is the angle theta which is required. Let's say this is the theta x which is required, right? So then we can apply tan theta to this triangle, right? So if I apply tan theta x, so then this will be equal to this component, since this is our y component and this one is our x component, right? So this will be our y divided by our x, and theta x will be equal to tan inverse, and our y is equal to 41.84. So I will write 41.84 divided by this 34.87. So this will give us theta x, and this will give us the magnitude. When we solve this equation, so theta x comes out to be 50.19 degrees, and the resultant magnitude is 54.47 kilonewton, right? And if we want to represent that resultant as a vector in a vector form, so then that resultant will be equal to this rx. So rx is 34.87, which is acting in the positive y direction, in the positive x direction, and this is acting in the positive y direction. So I will write plus 41.84, and this is in kilonewtons, right? And this is that theta x, which the resultant max with the positive x axis is. So this is the solution of this particular problem.